Hello, YouTube cookers. Welcome to my channel. Today, I will briefly show you my delicious Caribbean conch fritters. There's so much you can do with a beautiful conch shell. These are just a few creative ideas I got from Google. This is the result of conch soaked in lemon. You can also just simply wash it off really well if you don't have time to soak it. First, you will need a food processor, and these are my preferred seasonings. I will get into more details later on in the video. Take the pieces of conch and distribute evenly into the food processor. I also forgot to mention that I asked the fish market clerk to tenderize it for me by banging it with a hammer. This makes it less tough and quicker to cook. You can tenderize it yourself by cooking it in a pressure cooker until soft, or boil it with garlic for at least 3 hours in a pot. You blend it for a few minutes until it looks chopped up. Add 2 celery sticks, broken or cut up, and place nicely into the processor. Make sure not to overflow the processor. 1/4 size of Scotch bonnet pepper, or any pepper of your choice. If you don't like spicy foods, leave out the pepper. Add 5 whole peeled garlic. Make sure you cut them up. Blend nicely until everything is chopped up really fine. Add it to the bowl with the minced up conch meat. Next, you're gonna add 1/2 of green pepper, sliced up, 1/2 of yellow pepper, nicely sliced up, 1/2 of red pepper, sliced up. Blend it all up as you did before, nicely fine. Remember, you are not trying to create liquid. You are basically mincing up the seasoning to a smaller content. Dump that into the bowl as well. Lastly, add 1/2 of an onion, blend, then add to the bowl. Next, into that bowl, you will add 1 egg, 1/2 cup of milk, a 1/4 cup of flour, 3 times. I added a 1/4 cup 3 times. Stir it up all nicely until you get it to a nice consistency. Remember, it should not be too watery. I actually ended up adding a little more sprinkles of flour to get it non-watery. Shakes of your own seasoning. I like Adobe, Complete, All-Purpose Seasoning Salt. And I added Cajun seasoning for a boost in taste. Stir it all up and blend well. Next, place a frying pan on the stove until hot. You will also need an ice cream scooper or a large spoon. You can make the fritters as small or as big as you like. fry until golden brown and flip to the other side.